Local pump prices going up for the 10th straight week. Diesel prices will see the biggest jump of 40 centavos per liter, while both kerosene and diesel prices will see a 20 centavo markup. Since July 11, pump prices have gone up by over 14 pesos, with diesel having the biggest increase. Oil industry players attribute the jump in fuel prices to Russia and Saudi Arabia extending their supply cuts. The Philippine Transportation Department set to distribute billions of pesos in fuel subsidies to over 1 million drivers affected by the continuous increase in oil prices. This after the release of funds by the Budget Department. According to the DBM, drivers in the country will receive a subsidy of up to 10,000 pesos.
Ang target namin ay ma-implemento within the next 2 days. Up to siguro pinaka-latest nito ay to September 15. So ang LTFRB ay now working with the other government agencies, no? Together with Land Bank, ang DILG, no? DTI. Alam ko na nahihirapan yung ating mga drivers, mga operators, kaya kami naman po sa Department of Transportation, sa LTFRB, no, ay talaga namang ginagawa namin yung lahat ng ating makakaya para maibigay kaagad itong tulong na to.
The Philippine Navy beefs up its fleet with the addition of 2 vessels donated by the U.S. Navy. Our correspondent Bianca Dava now joins us with more details. Bianca, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. Defense Secretary Gilberto Chidoro Jr. on Monday led the christening and commissioning rites of 2 newly acquired Alvarez-class patrol vessels at the Philippine Navy headquarters here in Manila. The Philippine Navy accepted the 2 Cyclone-class patrol vessels from the U.S. Navy last March. They were formerly known as USS Monsoon and USS Chinook. They were delivered to the Philippines last May through the Excess Defense Article Program. EDAs are U.S. Department of Defense and U.S. Coast Guard-owned assets that are no longer needed and declared excess by the U.S. Armed Forces. Now, these excess equipment may be offered at reduced or even no cost to eligible foreign recipients like the Philippines. Today, the ships were renamed BRP Valentin Diaz and BRP Ladislao Diwa in honor of the 2 Filipino patriots who were among the founders of the Katipunan. According to the Philippine Navy, the 2 vessels will be part of the Alvarez-class patrol vessels currently in service with the Navy's Littoral Combat Force. These 55-meter vessels will be able to complement the Navy's patrol gunboats in their campaign to ensure the safety and security within the littoral waters of the Philippines. The lead ship of the ACPD, the BRP General Mariano Alvarez, was acquired by the Philippine Navy from the U.S. Navy in 2004 and has played significant roles during the counterinsurgency operations in Mindanao. Chidoro, who was the guest of honor and speaker in today's ceremony, said the 2 newly acquired vessels are a welcome and a timely addition because the sooner that the Philippines can complete its littoral defenses, the sooner the armed forces and its partners can pursue a more robust position in defending our country's sovereign rights in our EEZ or exclusive economic zone. Chidoro noted that aside from strengthening diplomacy, the Philippines must also boost or upgrade the capabilities of our armed forces for us to be more responsive to the challenges of the times. Meanwhile, Chidoro also called the actions of the China Coast Guard during the recent rotational and resupply mission to Irian Shoal as irresponsible. Last Friday, 2 Philippine Coast Guard ships escorted supply boats, which on a resupply mission to Irian Shoal, to the BRP Sierra Madre in Irian Shoal. And during that time, Chinese Coast Guard vessels as well as maritime militia vessels conducted dangerous maneuvers against the Philippine Coast Guard ships and even the resupply boats.
Well, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. flies to his hometown in Ilocos Norte to celebrate the birthday of his late father. Let's get details now from our correspondent, Pia Gutierrez. Pia, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. paid tribute to the late dictator and President Ferdinand Edrelin Marcos as he led a commemoration of his father's 106th birthday in their hometown, Batac, Ilocos Norte, on Monday, September 11. The Philippine leader offered a wreath of flowers at the Marcos Monument in Batac during a short ceremony to honor his father. The first family also attended a Thanksgiving Mass at the Immaculate Conception Parish, also in Batac. And during his speech, the president recalled the rich legacy of his late father, also known as Apolacay, to the nation. For the president, his late father was a true Filipino and Ilocano icon whose exceptional mind matched the nation-loving spirit that he possessed and that he demonstrated. He also expressed hope that Marcos Sr.'s values, ideals, and visions for the country will spur young leaders and government officials into aspiring for greater roles and more meaningful endeavors, much like how these have inspired him. Malacanang earlier declared September 11 as a special non-working holiday in the province of Ilocos Norte to mark the 106th birth anniversary of Ferdinand Marcos Sr. The president also led the launch of the Rice Paddy Art by the Mariano Marcos State University and the Philippine Rice Research Institute, which has his face and his governance tagline, Bagong Pilipinas, drawn on a rice field. According to the MMSU and PhilRice, this is in support of the president's agriculture program and food security efforts. The rice paddy art, which began in Japan in 1993, has been conducted annually by the MMSU and PhilRice since 2018 to pay tribute to exemplary individuals who have significant contributions to agriculture and nation building while showcasing innovative rice production technologies and promoting agritourism in the province. Marcos Jr. said in his speech that the Department of Agriculture is working to ensure that agricultural research, as well as the technologies coming from it, will be made available to the benefit of the farmers and make sure that as government increases rice production, the profits from these will ultimately redound to the farmers themselves.
Manila's finance chief asserts the controversial Maharlika Investment Corporation should be headed by a Filipino. Secretary Benjamin Diokno made that remark after the Treasury Bureau last week began accepting applications for senior members of the board. Weeks before the September 27 deadline, all positions on the board are yet to be filled. These include a president, a CEO, two regular directors, and three independent directors. Diokno earlier said the country's sovereign wealth fund would be operational before the year ends. The finance department also supporting calls for the temporary reduction of import tariffs on rice. Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno says they are proposing to cut the 35% rice import tariff rate to between 0 to 10%. This is part of a comprehensive set of measures to help ensure stability, which also include the timely importation of rice by the private sector, the full implementation of the super green lane that will fast-track processing and clearance of shipments, and working with tollway operators to temporarily exempt trucks carrying agricultural products from the increase in toll fees. Diokno, meanwhile, expresses full support for the president's price ceiling executive order, which he admits caught him and NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan by surprise. He says the stopgap measure serves as a lifeline that extends much-needed relief to Filipinos. The price cap on rice might be lifted in the next 2 weeks. That's according to Philippine Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual. Now, he says the government is expecting more rice supply in the coming weeks due to the harvest season and arrival of imported grain. Pascual also justifying the move to impose the highly contested price ceiling on rice.
The price cap was imposed. It was not a standalone measure. This was done alongside efforts to address the issue of hoarding, profiteering, smuggling, and cartelization. And there were parallel efforts to take care of these actions, anti-competitive market action. The law, so-called law of surprise demand works in an ideal situation, you know, when there is a balance of supply and demand forces. If there is an imbalance, like a manipulation or hoarding, then some intervention would help address the balance. It's a solution that's called for given the circumstances within which this EO 39 was issued.
RC Balisacan.
As for former National Economic and Development Chief Chelito Habito, he believes the government must go after cartels instead of implementing a price cap. Habito also expressing disappointment on the leadership of President Marcos in the Agriculture Department.
This has to be measured in terms of how much does it cost our taxpayers. The problem is there's a thin line between so-called hoarding and really rice stocking. It's not enough to be looking for evidence that there's a lot of rice being stored in some warehouse and then say that's hoarding. As many people have expressed, the disappointment really is in that he was not able to give it the amount of time that really it demands. And in fact, I've always called agriculture the backbone of our Philippine economy. It's simply too important to be left. The time that was devoted by the president directly made it difficult to really get a clear direction from the Department of Agriculture.